Hello everyone and welcome to the second lecture. And in this lecture we will talk about standard deviation and variance. These are two other important mathematical numbers, statistical quantities, and these are also very frequently used in machine learning, and it is important that we learn more about them. So we'll start with learning about standard deviation. So standard deviation is a number that describes how spread out the values are. A low standard deviation means that most of the numbers or the values are close to the mean, and a high standard deviation means that the values are spread out over a wider range. They are spread far apart from the mean. Okay, so as an example here, we have a list with the speeds of 7 cars, 86, 87 and so on. And if you find the standard deviation, you will find it out as 0.9. So what this means is that most of the values are within 0.9 from the mean value. And if you find out the mean using the method I taught you in my previous lecture, you will see that it comes out to 86.4. Okay, so the list we considered earlier had elements spread over a small range, but what if they are spread over a wide range? So here in this example we have 7 values spread over a wide range, and if you calculate the standard deviation, it comes out to 37.85, and this means that the values are within 37.85 from the mean, and if you calculate the mean, it comes out to 77.4. So this is obviously a list with a wider range than the previous list, and as you just saw, a higher standard deviation indicates that the values are spread over a wider range, and a smaller or a lower standard deviation indicates that the values are centered around the mean, close to the mean. Okay, so calculating the standard deviation by hand is very involved, and there is no need to do that if you can use Python, basically is what I'm trying to say. So here we have two examples. Both of them are similar except for the input list. So in the first example, we are first of all importing the NumPy package, creating the list, then using the std method from the NumPy package to find out the standard deviation. In the second example also, we are doing a similar thing except the list speed is different. Okay, so in the first example, the elements are not spread out a lot, and thus their standard deviation, if you calculate it, if you compute it, it comes out to 0.9. And in the second example, the elements are spread over a wider range, and thus their standard deviation is also high. Okay, so let's see how this is done using Python. Okay, so Python, I've called the first example 01.py, and you see when I ran it, the standard deviation, it came to about 0.9. On the other hand, if I run the second example, you will see that I get 37.84, which is a considerably larger value or a higher value than 0.9. Okay, moving on. Now let's talk about the second quantity, variance. Variance is also similar to standard deviation in the sense that it also indicates how spread out the values are. And also, you can actually derive the variance from the standard deviation. If you take the square root of the variance, you get the standard deviation. And if you take the square of the standard deviation, you get the variance. So as an example, let us find out the variance of the list of numbers 32, 111, so on. You can read it on the screen. Okay, so what if you wanted to find it out manually? First, what you would do is you would find the mean, which you can do by simply summing all the elements and dividing by the total number of elements. You will see that it comes out to 77.4. Then what you need to do next is that you need to find a difference from the mean of each element. So 32, it is minus 45.4 from the mean, 111 is 33.6 from the mean, and so on. Third step, what you need to do is you need to square the differences that you just found out. So minus 45.4 square gives you 26, 2061.16, 33.6 square gives you 1128.96 and so on. So the variance, you can finally be able to calculate variance by calculating the mean of these differences that you just found out. So as you can see, it's a pretty tedious process and it will take you a lot of time. And also there's a lot of scope for silly mistakes. But NumPy and Python are here to save the day. You can use the var method from the NumPy package to calculate the variance. You can simply import the library, create the list, and then you can find the variance using the var method, numpy.var. Okay, so let us see if this works. And yes, see, it worked. I got 1432.244 and so on. Okay, so that's all I had to cover regarding variance and standard deviation. You don't need to go into a lot of detail. Even being clear with this much would be good enough. Okay, see you in the third lecture. Bye.